Hi, welcome to On This Day in Tudor History with me, Claire Ridgway, and Ari the cat, who's sort of scrambling around by my feet. Now, where am I taking you back to today? Well, I'm taking you back to the reign of King Henry VIII. For On This Day in Tudor History, the 21st of May 1524, Thomas Howard, 2nd Duke of Norfolk, courtier, landowner and soldier, died at his home, Framlingham Castle in Suffolk. He was about 81 years of age at his death, an amazing age for a Tudor man. Now, Norfolk was the grandfather of Queens Anne Boleyn and Catherine Howard, but there was far more to him than that. So let me tell you a few Thomas Howard facts. Well, Howard was born in 1443 in the county of Suffolk in East Anglia, and he was the eldest son of John Howard, 1st Duke of Norfolk, and his wife Catherine, daughter of William Lord Malins. Not much is known about Howard's early life, but he started his court career in the late 1460s, serving King Edward IV as a henchman. In late 1470, when King Henry VI was restored to the throne and Edward IV was forced into exile in the Low Countries, Howard took sanctuary at St John's Abbey in Colchester. Edward IV returned to England to claim the throne in the spring of 1471, and on the 14th of April 1471, Howard was one of those men who fought on Edward's side at the Battle of Barnet. Howard was actually badly injured during the battle, but he was rewarded for his loyal service by the victorious King Edward IV by being made Esquire of the Body. In 1472, Thomas Howard married Elizabeth Tilney. She was the daughter of Frederick Tilney, and she'd recently been widowed. She'd been married to Humphrey Boucher, who was actually killed at the Battle of Barnet. So the two of them got married, and they had three surviving sons and two daughters together, including Thomas Howard, 3rd Duke of Norfolk, Elizabeth Howard, the mother of Anne Boleyn, and Edmund Howard, who was, of course, the father of Catherine Howard. Their other children, unfortunately, died young. Thomas Howard was knighted in January 1478 as part of the marriage celebrations for Edward IV's young son, Richard, who'd just been made Duke of York and Duke of Norfolk, and Anne Mowbray, the only surviving child of John de Mowbray, 4th Duke of Norfolk. Historian David Head points out that this marriage extinguished the Howards' faint claim to lands and titles of their Mowbray kinsmen, and it may have determined their role in the events that followed. King Edward IV died on the 9th of April 1483, and Thomas Howard and his father John supported Richard, Duke of Gloucester, when he took the throne as King Richard III in June 1483. Thomas Howard helped with the arrest of Lord Hastings, and he also bore the sword of state at Richard's coronation and served him as steward at his coronation banquet. On the 28th of June that year, his father was created Duke of Norfolk and Thomas was made Earl of Surrey. Thomas was also granted an annuity of £1,000 and both men received lands. Thomas was also appointed to the Privy Council and elected as a Knight of the Order of the Garter. Father and son, John and Thomas Howard, helped put down the Duke of Buckingham's rebellion, and then they both fought on the side of Richard III at the Battle of Bosworth in August 1485. John, who was Richard's commander of the vanguard, was sadly killed, and Thomas was taken prisoner by Henry Tudor's forces. Thomas ended up being attainted for treason at Henry VII. That's Henry the Tudor had, of course, come to the throne after the Battle of Bosworth. He was attainted for treason at Henry VII's first parliament. He was imprisoned in the Tower of London for 3 years, and he was stripped of his earldom. In 1487, during the rebellion of the Earl of Lincoln, Thomas Howard, who was imprisoned in the Tower of London, was offered the chance to escape, but he refused, perhaps proving his loyalty to the new King Henry VII. He was then released from prison, and after that he was able to prove his loyalty more by serving King Henry VII as lieutenant in the north, as Lord High Treasurer, and also as a diplomat. He ended up being restored to his title Earl of Surrey in 1489. While Thomas was King's lieutenant in the north, he repelled an attack by the Scottish king, King James IV. James IV was supporting the pretender Perkin Warbeck, and Thomas was subsequently involved in negotiations for the marriage of King Henry VII's daughter, Margaret Tudor, and the Scottish king. And he escorted Margaret Tudor to Scotland in 1503 for her marriage to King James IV. In 1497, following the death of his first wife, Elizabeth Tilney, Surrey married Agnes Tilney, who was actually his first wife's cousin, and the couple went on to have six surviving children, including William Howard, 1st Baron Howard of Effingham. Thomas Howard's diplomatic work for King Henry VII included being part of the negotiations for the marriage of Henry VII's eldest son, Arthur, Prince of Wales, and Catherine of Aragon, who was, of course, the daughter of the Catholic monarchs Ferdinand and Isabel of Spain. He also led negotiations with the Holy Roman Emperor Maximilian in 1508 regarding a marriage between Henry VII's other daughter, Mary, and the Emperor's grandson, Charles, the future Emperor Charles V. The betrothal ended up, it was negotiated, but it ended up being broken off. And of course, Mary married King Louis XII of France. In 1509, Surrey acted as an executor of Henry VII's will, and he went on to serve the new king, Henry VIII, as Earl Marshal. He was created Duke of Norfolk in 1514, following his service and his success at the Battle of Flodden against the Scots, which he'd fought in 1513. And he'd led those troops at the Battle of Flodden while the king was campaigning in France in a not very successful campaign. What is amazing is that the Duke of Norfolk here, at the time, at the Battle of Flodden, leading these troops and being so successful. He was 70 years of age at that battle. That's quite incredible. His son, who was also named Thomas, was made Earl of Surrey. In 1514, as a diplomat, he was involved in the negotiations for the marriage of Henry VIII's sister, Mary, and King Louis XII of France. And he was also part of the escort that accompanied Mary to France when she was preparing to marry the French king. In May 1517, when he was aged 74, Thomas Howard, who is now Duke of Norfolk, helped put down the evil May Day riots in London. And in 1521, as Lord High Steward, he presided over the treason trial of Edward Stafford, 3rd Duke of Buckingham. In 1522, he was now sickly, he was ailing, and he resigned as Lord Treasurer and retired from court to his home of Framlingham in Suffolk, Framlingham Castle, where he died on this day in 1524 at the grand old age of 81. He was buried in a lavish funeral on the 22nd of June 1524 at Thetford Priory. Historian David Head describes how at his funeral there was a procession of 400 hooded men bearing torches and an elaborate bier surmounted with 100 wax effigies and 700 candles, and that the sermon on the text, "Behold the Lion of the Tribe of Judah triumphs," Revelations 5 verse 5, so terrified the congregation that the mourners fled the church. Wouldn't you have loved to have been a fly on the wall at that funeral service, saying, with all of those hooded men, torches, candles, and then an amazing sermon that saw the congregation running out of the door in fear? Oh, fabulous. The priory where he was laid to rest on that day was dissolved in the dissolution of the monasteries, and so his remains were moved to the church of St. Michael the Archangel in Framlingham, where they still are today. At his death, the Duke's estate was worth £4,500 per year. And I looked that up on the currency converter on National Archives website, and it's well over £2 million in today's money. So he was a very, very wealthy man at his death. Of course, he didn't live to see his granddaughters, Anne Boleyn and Catherine Howard, become queen consorts to King Henry VIII, or to see their subsequent executions, or to see his great-granddaughter Elizabeth become Queen of England. Interestingly, the Howard family still hold the Dukedom of Norfolk today, with the present Duke of Norfolk being Edward William Fitzalan Howard, who is also Earl Marshal of England, just like that Thomas Howard. Also on this day in Tudor history, the 21st of May 1535, reformer and Bible translator William Tyndale was arrested in Antwerp. Why was he arrested and why didn't King Henry VIII help him? Well, you can find out in last year's video, which I'll give you a link to. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm in a very sunny and bright Spain. You can subscribe to the channel by clicking that subscribe button just there. You can hit the bell to be notified as these videos go live, and you can give me a like and leave me a comment. I'll be back tomorrow. Bye bye.